Sonia Rodrigues. Today is Wednesday, the 11th of August, 2021. We are going to reflect on the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 18, verses 15 to 20. Let's open our hearts and listen. If another member of the church sins against you, go and point out the fault when the two of you are alone. If the member listens to you, you have regained that one. But if you are not listened to, take one or two others along with you, so that every word may be confirmed by the evidence of two or three witnesses. If the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if the offender refuses to listen even to the church, let such a one be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you lose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among them. The Gospel of the Lord. We might recall the story about two goats who wanted to go in opposite directions by crossing a narrow bridge built across the river. Though they were aware that the bridge was not broad enough for both of them to use it together, they reached the center of the bridge and stopped, waiting for the other to go back and give way. Neither wanted to compromise, and in the ensuing argument and fight, both of them fell into the river. A short while later, another pair of goats arrived on the same bridge, wanting to go in opposite directions yet again. But this time, good sense prevailed and one goat lay down on the bridge, allowing the other goat to step over him and go across. That way, both of them were able to cross the bridge peacefully. We are all human beings created in the image of God, yet we are made unique and none of us are carbon copies of each other. We think differently, hold distinct opinions, and approach life situations with varied perspectives. Naturally, clashes or disputes are bound to arise in our daily interactions. However, that does not mean we need to get into arguments just to prove a point or to put someone down. It is usually pride and ego that gets in the way of a compromise or solution. If handled sensitively and sensibly, matters can usually be sorted amicably. And a little bit of common sense and humility can go a long way to resolve even tricky situations. When we have a disagreement with someone, our normal tendency is to go and talk to someone else about it instead of talking to the person directly. This approach is unhealthy because firstly, we remove the actual person from the equation, so we do not have his or her perspective. And secondly, we have an extra opinion which can be biased and cause complications. So 1 minus 1 is equal to a zero solution. Not a very effective equation, right? In today's gospel, Jesus advises us to first speak directly to the person alone, and also very importantly, to include him, that is Jesus, in the conversation. He reminds us that where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among them. So when he is present in any situation, his grace flows, his wisdom abides, and solutions come through. So 1 plus Jesus is equal to infinite solutions. That's one equation that always works wonders. We might not always be able to control what happens to us or how people behave towards us, but we can certainly control how we react or respond. And this applies both ways. How we respond when we are confronted for our mistake is also important and can set a powerful example for others. All of this requires a whole lot of love, the fruit of love that comes from the Holy Spirit, along with an amazing package of gifts which guide, strengthen, and empower us to discern, act wisely, and seek solutions amidst conflict. So let us strive to build bridges with love and thereby become peacemakers as Jesus so beautifully reminds us, blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for guiding us in every walk of life. Whenever we are faced with any kind of conflict, teach us to follow your precepts and invite you into the situation so that your presence will prevail and your love will enable us to build bridges in our relationships. We ask this in your mighty, holy and precious name. Amen. God bless you.